spring when we get our water. Clean drinking water. Best water around here. Best water. And that's the place where we shoot our rifles up there. Rifle range runs all the way down. John and Paul enjoy shooting BB guns and tin can targets, me and myself, meaning Kevin Collins, the ingenuitive man of all trades. We're all road. It's pretty raining out now. It's 423.88. Should be at work right now. I should have been there last night too. Oh well. Fix John's BB gun. Too old. Well, it's been nice being here. That's the Marines guy. Oh well, we'll start Marines and we'll get
there. Don't shoot! Don't shoot! I thought you'd have to shoot!
John! Say hi!
Hi.
Down to the looking glass. Right. We are shooting.
The BB gun.
Oh, come on, shoot.
We'll try. Be patient.
Sure. Look at you, little BBs.
All right. Direct hit.
You sent my battleship.
Jokes that I don't know if he made up or not, but if he did, don't laugh at him because he can't help it if he acts like that. So here we are. We'll come back to John now. All right, go ahead, John.
Well, okay, what is Arkansas?
What?
The same thing, Tennessee. What did Delaware?
What?
A New Jersey. What did Mississippi?
What?
A Minnesota. What did Maryland?
What?
I don't know
why
I laughed at. Goodbye.
I said goodbye. I think that was...
Push the red button. Don't cast
news.
I got one. Okay, this is a book now. How to Open a House by Just in Time.
Smashing John in the face. Oh, a human.
No problem.
What drives people to this limit of no end? How?
Go ahead. Make my day. What?
See, my friend, man, he's a real failure. You know why?
Why?
Because, like, one of his greatest ancestors, he was a failure, too. He was a social director of the Alamo.
No problem. I'm setting up for that joke of the day.
I must say, that's a fairly small city.
This is Miss April. Yeah. Miss April.
Donald Spelling. Yeah.
Posing for Playboy.
I certainly do. The
magazine.
Right.
Fontal Rod Gilroy. I am really weird. Yes.
Keep
isn't very much more to say. You can see I'm weird. I have been operated on. They opened me up because I was such a good-hearted guy. They took my heart out, and they put a Big Ben alarm clock in there. Now I know I'm very much alive because I keep hearing myself saying,
alligator to your pan.
And you swallow a clock.
I once was married because she was a crocagator. You know what a crocagator is?
No.
Man, I tell you, that's the meanest animal in the whole world. The meanest. There's nothing more mean than that. What?
Say, what's, why is he so mean?
Why is he so mean?
Well, on the one end, he has the head of an alligator. On the other end, he's got the head of a crocodile. And mean.
What's in the middle?
Nothing. That's what makes him so mean.
What about the tail?
That's what makes him so mean. And that is it. Scorpion, do you read me? Take your finger out of your eye. Get your finger out of your eye when you're using that camera. And get the other one out of your nose.
Hey, Martin, could you mind if I film this interview with Mr. Kovac?
Okay.
Mr. Kovac, I understand that when you were a young man,
yes,
you were in the Army. Is it not true that you were an amateur fighter?
This is true.
And how many fights did you have?
13.
And how many did you win?
I lost them all. No, that's not true.
How many did you win?
I won 12 and one third. 12 and a third. 12 and a third. And the last fight I had, I went one round, and I was fighting a friend of mine. And we hurt each other pretty bad. I don't know who got hurt worse than whom, but I quit boxing then. And we went into the shower room, and we threw up together. This was the end of my boxing career. He went on to glorious things. He had his nose cut open. He lost several teeth. His brain got a little mushy. Of course, both of our brains were a little mushy to begin with.
Was he Muhammad Ali?
No, he wasn't Muhammad Ali, but it didn't do him any good. And he went to the I forget what they call it, the Corps, the 7th Corps European Golden Gloves.
How did you get into boxing?
And he was smashed up good there by a fellow by the name of Eddie Crook, who ended up winning the Golden Gloves Championship. How did I get into boxing? This is a very interesting question. I got into boxing because I didn't want to go on guard duty. Yes.
Tell us that story.
One of the people sleeping thinks this is very boring and is insulted by the fact that he can't sleep while I fart. Let me talk. The story of what, getting into boxing is very simple. I was in the 2nd Armored Cavalry Division, serving in Nuremberg, Germany.
How was yours?
1957. And I had been playing football and baseball, and I got used to that kind of life because it was even better than being in the intelligence corps, which is pretty hard to beat, but if you're an athlete, or as we refer to lovingly, jock straps, you even get more privileges. So, I decided I would turn in my Secret Service badge and get the jock strap, you know? So anyway, when football season was over and baseball season was over, I was always in danger of being sent back to the unit, which would mean I'd, you know, have to show up for work, eat regular Army food, get a special foods, salute people and all that. I don't want to do that. If I wanted to do that, I could join the Girl Scouts or the Boy Scouts.
You sound like another guy I know. His name is Hal.
Hal?
Clay Pottery.
Hal Witzer? You know Hal Witzer?
No.
Oh, you don't know Hal Witzer? So anyway, rather than go back to the unit and be a real soldier, I decided to box in between. So then I could go from football, the end of football season, to the beginning of baseball season. But it got pretty rough. Things got pretty rough. They fed you well and you didn't have a lot to do, but when you got in the between the ropes, you paid the bill. So, sort of speak, you paid the bill. And then boxing's a nasty sport. I wouldn't recommend anybody get in that. It's a very, very, very nasty, bad sport. And I think I made a good choice because there's probably at least an eighth of my brain that's left that has not been damaged. So I have enough wit about me now that I can successfully, once in a while, go and porcupine hunt. I'm a specialist in porcupine.
Tell us that story, please.
Oh, the story.
About the porcupine.
Oh, yes. But I can't tell the story because you just gave the ending.
Well, you
have just destroyed one of the best stories of this hunting weekend.
Well, excuse
you have wiped it out completely.
You're the one who mentioned the porcupine.
I know, you were the one that mentioned the punchline. What good is this story?
Give us the story.
Give me a break. Well, okay, I will tell you the story. I have gotten myself up very early with the help of Frank Water, who kicked me out of the bed at 5 o'clock. I say 5, not 4, not 6, 5.
Gotcha.
Is that a commentary on the quality of this videotaping? Well, let me tell you something. With that boy. Take a look at this boy. Now, there's something wrong with that boy. Wrong with this boy, too.
You guys are weird.
Yeah. You got that right.
Serious weird.
You got that right, man.
Back to the beach.
With the story.
So, once I was up, I began to get dressed. I put on John Doman's shoes. I put on Frank Bottle's pants. I don't know whose shirt I had. And then, Zorba the Greek. Oh, is this what Zorba's? So, after putting everyone else's clothes on, I hurried out to the woods.
My underwear.
As it was beginning to get light. And also beginning to rain. But I thought, I have someone's raincoat on. I will continue. So I continued right past the Schmidt house. You know where the Schmidt house is?
What's that?
The Schmidt house is right behind the cabin over here.
What is it?
That's exactly what I said it is. It's the Schmidt house. You go there when you need to schmidt.
Whose underwear did you have on?
I had my own underwear. I could tell. I recognized them right away. So anyway, as I passed the Schmidt house, I headed into the woods, and here comes this garbage-eating dog that we have in the cabin. We have a dog who does the finest service for garbage disposal. We do not need a garbage disposal in this cabin. We have the dog. This dog eats all the trash, aluminum foil, tin cans.
And then burns it.
He doesn't burn it. He converts it to methane gas. And then he comes near my bed at night and he abuses me all night long, making funny sounds and smelling terrible. Normally, I like dogs, but this dog, I'm not sure. Back to the hunting story.
Yes.
I am walking in the woods and I said, I hear something.
Okay.
I said, maybe I better stop and make sure. So I stopped suddenly to see if I could hear something. And the garbage dog bumped into me so hard he almost knocked me over. I said, oh, I was right. I did hear something. The dog is following me. So I brought the dog back past the Schmidt house into the cabin. Put the dog in the cabin, closed the door, here I go again. Soon as I get past the Schmidt house in the woods, here comes this same noise again. I said, he's not going to bump into me now. So I jumped behind a tree to duck at the tree. I ran right into the tree. The garbage has made his brain very bad. John Dolan Jr. the Turd is not sleeping. He's laughing. He's laughing. I bring the dog back again past the Schmidt house into the cabin. And I said to the people in the cabin, do not let this garbage hound out of the cabin. So then I go back out past the Schmidt house. I think I stopped this time because I had enough of that Schmidt. So I continued on into the woods and I'm going and going. I'm way in the woods and I hear this sound. I say, oh, boy, here comes that crazy garbage dog again. And I was going to yell at him, and I turned around and I said to these 12 deer, go back to the cabin! They did not listen to me. They almost ran me over. It was like a stampede. So then I have hidden myself in a pit. I have crawled into this pit, and I have gotten very comfortable. And I was all set up, and it started to hail. Was very cold, but I said to myself, if you want to be a true turkey hunter, you must remain very still, and if you just breathe slowly, you will freeze right on the spot, and you would be a very good turkey hunter. So I did this. About 2 hours later, the sun came out, and I thawed out and began to move again, and I heard this chirp, chirp, chirp. I said, oh boy, I am lucky. And this new Big Ben I have put in here started to go pump, 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 pump. And I have turned around very slowly. And I'm looking for a turkey. I don't see any turkey, but I hear this cheep, cheep, cheep. Then I looked up in a tree. I said, oh boy. And then the alarm clock went off in the Big Ben. So I picked my gun up and I said, I'm going to shoot the turkey. And then the bad angel have come in my ear and he have said, shoot him! I said, okay! Then the good angel have come in the other ear, he said, what if it's a hen? I said, oh, I don't shoot no lady.
What's a hen?
Female.
Sorry, the camera doesn't know.
What a stupid camera. So, the good angel have said this and I said, no, I don't want to shoot no ladybirds, no. You know ladybird? Oh, you don't know ladybird. Anyway, I said, there's only one thing to do. Sneak up on this. So, I have gotten out of my pit, and I went very slowly, very slowly, closer and closer. And I'm saying to myself, if that sucker moves, the bad angel's going to win, because as soon as he moves a feather, pow! And then I'll check to see if he has a beard or not. It did not fly away. It just moved a little bit, but it did not fly away. And I ended up right under the tree, and I put the gun up, and I was looking right in the eyeballs of a porcupine. That's the end of this sad story.
I have a question.
Yes.
What was making the chirping sound?
Right when all this action is taking place, it takes me 1 hour to go from the pit to the tree where this flying porcupine is living. And another hunter comes out of the woods with a little bitty corn cob turkey call, and he's going, squawk, squawk, squawk.
Just like that?
Why is
he doing that?
Was that you making the hen call? He said, no, it was the porcupine.
Why was he making the hen call?
Why was he making a hen call?
The camera wants to know.
What do you think answers a hen's call?
A turkey. The camera said that.
What kind of a turkey?
A wild turkey.
What kind of a wild turkey?
A rooster.
Male.
A male.
You got that.
Cobbler.
A cobbler, yes, a cobbler. A cobbler's a piece of pie, boy. You better remain a cameraman. You want to grow up to be a good porcupine hunter? You listen to me. I will teach you how to shoot porcupines. Porcupines are not easy.
cabin.
42488.
Anybody see pictures of the floor?
Anybody see any elastic bands right here?
They're
like,
bungee cords.
I gotta go to the Schmidt house.
Go to the G's.
I'm gonna take one of the hats right now.
Just be careful, please, whatever you do. I don't have enough money to pay for that.
Okay.
Hope that's not on.
It is on.
Well, then you got a good shot of my Adam's apple.
Take it off, Martin. Don't look at her while you're walking.
Thank you.
This is Trapper Shane. Just so I get a picture of it, so get you everybody. There are the rugs. I'm gonna beat them out and then get out of here. There's my dad out of the cabin. Hi, Dad.
How you doing, Mark?
Mr. Howe. See, there's our car all packed up to leave. It's been nice being here for last weekend. There's our cans we shoot at. It's BB gun. Here, in the Shannon State Forest. There's Mr. Kovac's truck. Down that, Mr. Kovac's truck, and down that road is Marshallville Camp, where we have our rifle range. Here's the road that goes past the cabin. Merrill Road. There's the Schmidt house. And Kevin's in there right now.
Hey, Frank.
Come here a sec.
Is there... Can you tell me which stuff is yours and what you could use as far as you had to?
Just that.
Mr. Hale.
No.
Ah, come on.
Is here.
That's about
Mr.
Best
Collins,
I can do.
Mr. Collins, pack it up.
Here's
the famous man himself!
I'd like you to meet a friend of mine.
Okay.
Butch Gazadich. Famous for his trolloping around with the Sundance Kid.
How you doing? Pleasure to meet you, George.
Butch Gazadich, a real pleasure. Tell him your real name.
Butch Gazadich.
No, your real name,
Butch Gazadich.
Konyevich. But the name was too long to put on the marquee, so they shortened it. Gazadich. In Italy, it's Gazadich.
I see.
In America, it's Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. That is the Sundance Kid right there. How do you do, Sundance Kid?
How are you?
Hold it up here because otherwise you won't be in the film.
There's Sundance Kid.
Hey, Frank, I'll leave the camera for you.
I did not notice.
I thought we packed the Kool-Aid.
Up here where the stool is my bed and Mr. Kovac's bed. Is Johnny a dumb in his bed? Is the turd?
Down
there. Mr. Conlowitz's bed? There's our lad. Up there's Mr. Howe's bed. You saw his debut before. And there is John Dimmitt, the first, second.
Oh, here's a case for us.
So, goodbye.
Here's a case for us.
It's Kevin's cap, hockey cap. Well, that's our last look at the
Kovac Schmidt house.
You got your porcupine hunting pajamas on, I see. You going porcupine hunting?
Yeah. Watch the back now. You ready, Kev?
Yeah.
Hang on. You ready?
Are we the Schmidt house? This is where you go when you have to take a Schmidt.
We are leaving.
I don't want to go home. I just want to stay here.
Forever.
Forever.
Trout.
So much fun.
Some fish stuff.
How'd you enjoy this weekend?
Oh, this is Tuesday's.
I don't want to go home either.
Have you seen my winter coat?
Yeah. Trigger that takes so many jackals.
Mr. Kovac, say goodbye to the camera.
Goodbye, camera. I hope you have become more sophisticated about the finer points of porcupine hunting. If you would like more lessons, I shall return, as General MacArthur said at one time. You have not learned anything?
No.
Well, Martin, I don't know if there's much hope then. If you can't learn from me, you just can't learn. That's it.
What's left of my BBs? They shot them all with their BB guns. Ripped and ruined many cans. Which served their purposes in the world of drinking. Lord hath taken these cans to a better place, where they will be able to be drinking by God.
Again! Oh no! Who is he?
I learned something from the
lavatory.
Now I know why he's acting up that way. Now it comes
to you had a porcupine hunt, right?
Porcupine what?
Hunt.
So you like know, a latrine or a lavatory?
I know it. I know the feeling.
That's the shit house.
The bunks, which we slept in. I slept in a top double. There's my hat rack, Cokie the Bear. More beds. This guy wants to a bed. The smell of the toker farted all night. In a chair. Coat rack. Our beloved TV.
Like it's fully just.
I already did that. I did the whole thing. I went around the whole house.
But imagine
gun rack, window.
It takes a long time to fill it.
Where's our kitchen?
What's your socks look like? Yeah. Oh, no, we didn't have anything like that. Must be here someplace.
My mistake.
Oh, there was a big white one laying down
there. Yeah, that was my mistake. I left the socks over here.
John picked them up.
Well, our cross pot get packed. Oh, here it is on the floor.
Hey, don't move, Kev. If your father sees this, which I'm going to show you.
Come on.
Get up.
One, the voyage home. Fishing trip one, the voyage home. Dun, dun.
of Gifford Run. So long for next year.
No, they will come back up in June. Flies are rising.
Now stay tuned for some action with deer. What
road is it?
Lost Run Road. Lost Run Road.
Just outside of the Blackie Sharon State Park.
I just want to thank our dear Lord for giving us such a great time together. It's crazy. It's beautiful weather we had.
Beautiful weather.
Most of the time.
Most of the time. It's good weather. That might be it. That looks like a lot more traffic's gone down in there.
Yeah. Where are you going?
Oh, we're going to go up here first. That's a good road we're going.
Right down back
here. Look at that little cabin. Isn't that neat?
That's the guy on the High Mountain Ranger.
Now, see, that's on private ground.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, he had two fences in front of it.
That's kind of the High Mountain Ranger's head.
Look at that. Look how big it is. It's long. That's a regular live around, year round type.
Yeah.
I wonder if you could find out who owns this five piece right here. This is a nice spot. It's high here.
Let's stop in at a real estate broker. Just get their number. They probably have some listings.
Yeah.
Thinking of, like a parcel or something like that.
Right.
But there's more this for.
Lost Run Road.
Don't take too much here because down later you get some fantastic vistas.
Okay, go crazy with your camera.
Here, just turn it over this way, Kevin, and end it. Get that way to run.
See the scenic views.
Oh, look at that.
Gifford Run.
This is Gifford Run. Thought we left it.
That one's straight, I don't think.
Ain't nothing to stop you from going off the edge of this thing.
When you backed up 3 feet, I didn't turn the wheel.
Dad.
I didn't see any road left on my side over here.
Hey, John, you can park the truck here and fish right from this.
Yeah.
What the heck about going down?
There he is.
Here, Kevin.
Right.
Is this thing running now?
No, Dad. I told you to
get the hit the right hander's buttons.
Yeah.
W and T. He's coming through. You have to hit that red button where it's coming.
Alright.
You have an auto focus, Kevin. Are we automatically focusing?
Yeah.
Greg is lost
out.
It's a power line, John.
Yeah, that would be the far end of that power line runs into another power line.
That'd be awesome to ride a four-wheeler on. That'd be awesome to ride a four-wheeler on.
Give
him a honk so he takes off.
Give him a honk, Dad.
Here, girl. Here. Come here.
She must be young.
They're wild. Still not that spooked.
Honk, Dad, honk.
Here, girl.
Here. Rawr!
Coming in, they're cutting it up.
This once stood great oaks and great trees of many sizes and height.
And now ripped down.
And now ravished and reaped by a tornado.
It happened in 1980.
God's wrath is a strange one. Or was something so devastating happened to this one.
Tornado come through this valley here.
Yep. It's ripped everything up.
Looks like weeds.
It's great.
It looks like weeds just trampled.
Yeah, stop right here. We'll get out.
There's plenty of shots you get a better play.
This is Mosquito Creek.
That's just a tributary of it. I don't know what.
We're gonna stop down here, Dad?
Yeah. Mosquito Creek runs up there. This is where we were fishing yesterday. There's a beaver pond
right here, Dad?
Down off in here.
My candy bar, John. Here is. What mountains are they? Mr. Donald, what mountains are they? Back here, there's too much moving around.
Dad, me and Kevin just switched. That's what we're going to do. No, John, you
no water coming down from between here.
Dad, how is it equal time to rain?
Where is it?
It's summertime.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
It's got two dams on the side.
Yeah. It's made out of sticks, just like you used to see in the textbooks. Big button sticks.
Yeah, looks like there might be one in there.
Dad's collecting his windshield.
Yeah. I have some illustrations and descriptions here.
And Johnny, and we're driving up to the Trapper Shanty. David's driving. How you doing, Dave?
Ah! Nothing.
So we're coming toward Lock Haven here, and is beautiful scene here coming out of this mountain. I love these farms around this mountainside here. So beautiful.